Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. Welcome to Railbookers webinar, seven of the most scenic routes in Switzerland. That's me. I'm Gareth Jones, not Gareth Joan. I should have corrected that from the morning's webinar, but forgive me. Gareth Jones, I'm your host today. What I would like to do first and foremost is for everybody just to, if you can see the questions area on the control bar, if you wouldn't mind just popping a little note in there saying hello, let me know where you're tuning in from. It'll be great to find out where everybody is. We had some people tuning in from Australia this morning, but also more importantly, just to make sure you can all hear me okay, you can all see the screen. Thank you, Barbara. First on the board, thank you very much. Hi, welcome. There's lots of you tuning in. Good stuff. Well, good. I'm glad it's all working okay. So let's begin, shall we? First of all, I'd just like to draw your attention to some special offers we have. Okay, so we've extended a special offer that we were running last week, Switzerland holidays for a limited time only to the end of this week. Save £300 per couple on any holiday to Switzerland featuring four nights or more. If you're traveling independently, don't worry, you still get a saving of £150. If there's two of you traveling, £100 per person. Okay. Now, if you're familiar with Railbookers, sorry about this, but if you're new to Railbookers, it's quite handy just to go over who we are and what we do, essentially. So, first of all, why do travelers love Railbookers? From 2 days to 2 years, our holidays go anytime, anywhere, any day, and they do. So we price our holidays out 2 years in advance, up till November 2022 at the moment. Saying that, I mean, obviously I'll admit it, our options are fairly limited in terms of where we can go at the moment, but who knows, next year, if you were to decide you wanted to go away next the following week or something, we're able to make sure everything is booked, all travel documentation to you, all in place up until 2 days prior to departure. Okay. All of our itineraries are customizable. What we mean by that is you can chop and change any of our holidays, anything we'll look at today, anything on our website, you can chop and change it as much as you like. So you can add nights on, take nights away, add in new destinations, change a hotel. We have great hotels in all the major destinations, range from 3-star to 5-star properties. Change class of travel, first class, second class. If you send us a list of places you want to go or a particular itinerary, Mr. Dave Shepherd, who's just come back to the UK from Singapore by train. Blimey, what a journey. Congrats. I hope it's enjoyable. I'm sure it was. We're able to put that together for you. We can put together all the rail elements, all the hotels together and put it together in one package. Bucket list experiences for special occasions. Now, obviously, private trains such as the Venice Simple Orient Express spring to mind. We're going to look today at Switzerland in particular. Some amazing journeys, truly spectacular, special journeys. Some amazing hotels, 5-star luxury to top of the mountain, beautiful little tiny boutique hotels. We've got any sort of rail holiday for all tastes, really, but really special, unique experiences. There are quite a few easily done by train. Independent holidays with freedom and flexibility. You're not traveling as part of a group. And it's a really important message to get across. We provide you with all the travel documentation, your train tickets, hotel vouchers, sightseeing experiences, the day trips and things like that. But the rest of the time, you're up to your own devices. You decide where you go for dinner. You decide where you go for lunch. It's all up to you. Okay. We are, of course, actor and adult protected. There we go. The maximum flexibility offer. It's something we've had in place this year. I think it's really important to be as flexible as possible. It's in place for all reservations made up until the end of the year as well. Essentially, you're covered by it. You can change the date of travel, postpone your trip up to 5 days prior to departure without any amendment fees from us. So we don't charge you to make any changes to the dates of travel. Okay. Wherever you are in the world on a Railbookers holiday, you can call a number and get through to one of our staff. The office in London, I'm based in York myself, speaking to you from the beautiful north. two offices in the US on either coast, an office in Toronto and an office in Sydney, Australia. So really is wherever you are in the world, you have an emergency number to call, you can contact one of the staff and we can help you with any problems or any issues or any questions you might have at that time. Okay. This map here, if you want a copy of this map, we can email it to you. Drop me a little note in the questions area, we'll get it emailed out to you. It does what it says on the tin. We take the mystery out of rail travel. We do. All those different coloured lines are different rail operators, scenic lines. We know them all. We know the quickest route. We know the best connections. We know the best places to change train, etc. We make it easy. These are just a handful of the direct rail partnerships we have. No problem, Dave. We'll get one for you. These are all some of the national rail operators. Now, also, we work with the private rail operators as well, be it Belmont for the BSOE, Golden Eagle, the luxury train across Russia. The direct partnerships with all of them. So we have different booking systems that are made available to the public. We have access to the train seats before they're made available to the public. I think it's really important also now, though, to look at what traveling by train looks like at the moment. Now, obviously, it's very fluid, it's changing a lot of places, but on the whole, of course, everyone's, as they have done most of the year, required facial coverings in stations and on trains for passengers and staff. Okay. Stopping the sale of food and drink on board trains. Again, depends where you are. Through sort of Central Europe, Germany, etc., the restaurant cars have stayed open, so you can get a cooked meal and things like that. Going into Italy, less so. Changing seat configuration allocation on board to allow for social distancing. Again, it depends where you are. It's become sort of a bit more open, shall we say. In France, the unions and the power that they have managed to convince the government to allow them to run trains at 100% capacity if they need to. In Italy, the government have been a bit more controlled on that. One thing which is quite popular, though, is the one-way system. So you get on the train on the one end of the carriage and off at the other end of the carriage, so very much people were walking in one direction and no kind of walking through the train either. Of course, increased cleaning and sanitation and contactless ticket control. Everyone's got to get used to having a ticket on your mobile phone or your tablet. We can, of course, print off a confirmation though, which is, you know, certainly suffices for a ticket as well if you prefer to have a bit of paper in your hand. One note I wanted to mention on the food and drink as well, though, and I think it's really important just to reiterate the difference between flying and taking a train. Flying, you can't take any food with you. You can't take a picnic with you, can you? Of course you can't. You can't even take a bottle of water. You don't have those restrictions of travelling by train. You can take a picnic with you. You can take a bottle of wine. It's not the most attractive look, obviously, having a bottle of wine trying to drink whilst wearing a mask. But in better times, we'll hopefully see next year. It's a lovely thing to do, just have a picnic, a bottle of wine, just watching the scenery pass by. Shall we have a look at some holidays now, shall we? Yes, I hear you cry. Good. Right, well, first up, Lake Como and the Bernina Express. This is just one example. We have plenty of options via the Bernina Express. It's possibly the most scenic way to travel into Italy, or between Switzerland and Italy. It's my favourite train journey. I met my wife on the Bernina Express train many years ago. 5 days, so 4 nights in total, a night in Zurich, 3 nights on Lake Como, starting price £1,099 from per person, it's from price. That's based on two people sharing. All the package costs will include all the travel highlighted, so all the trains, the flight back to a UK airport, doesn't have to be London, local airport, sort that out. Hotel accommodation, minimum 3-star, breakfast as well at the hotel, and all necessary reservations also. Here, train out, flight back. If you wanted to take the train back as well, no problem at all. We can change that easily. Starting price will be a little more, just train travel sadly can't compete with budget airlines, but who knows what the future will look like at this stage. The Bernina Express, though, often found at the top of a lot of people's list as the most scenic rail journey in Europe, if not the world, and rightly so. Some of the highest peaks of the Alps you go past, these lakes, which that image does look very colourful, I agree, but the lakes are that colourful, beautiful, pristine, clear Alpine lakes. it sort of meanders over these amazing mountain passes and then slowly starts dropping down and down as it comes into Italy and through this the Poschiavo Valley into Tirano in northern Italy. It's gorgeous, it really is. And the change in landscape, the valley is kind of palm tree lined, so from this alpine heights of the Alps, snow covered all the way all through the year, dropping down into it is amazing. You go over the Brusio Viaduct, which is this viaduct here, which you see there, the valley looks like kind of a toy town in a way, really. It's got that feel because the mountains are so huge. That goes around 360 degrees and comes out under the tunnel. If it went at any speed, it would be a roller coaster, but it doesn't. It's nice and gentle. You can actually open the windows, get a good photo out of the window is the best way to do it, if you don't get the sun glaze on the front through the windows. It's an amazing journey, it really is. It runs throughout the year, so you haven't got to worry about any seasonality, etc. Breathtaking, really is. And at the end of it, you relax on Lake Como for 3 nights as well. It's in Como itself. We've got a couple of hotels dotted around the lake if you want to go a bit further as well. A great day trip up to Bellagio, for example, or there's a lovely mountain funicular, Brunate, lovely village up in the hills above Como. You get some spectacular views across the lake itself. Beautiful. Next, we're going to stay in Switzerland, Swiss lakes and mountains from Zurich. So it's a week. It's a week. It's 7 nights, 8 days. Starting price from £1,839 per person. Again, train out, flight back. This time flying back from Geneva. Great thing about Switzerland, and particularly in flying, the airports, Geneva and Zurich, are so well connected with the rest of the country by train. You can literally fly in, go down to the train station, jump on a train to pretty much anywhere in Switzerland, and they're so regular and so easy. Here, overnight in Zurich, and then down to Chur, the capital of Graubünden. It's really big, one of the biggest cantons in Switzerland, in the heart of the Alps. And this here, they speak Romansh, it's a tiny dialect that's only spoken in this region of Switzerland. It's amazing. You've got a day trip on the Bernina from Chur down to Tirano and back up again. So the full length of the express two ways. It's a lovely day that because you see the scenery in two different lights, the morning light and the afternoon light. It takes on a completely different world. It's beautiful. From Chur, take the Glacier Express, two-thirds of it through to Brig, the most scenic part of the journey. And then Brig, take a couple of little small short train journeys up to Interlaken in the heart of the Bernese Oberland. 2 nights there, a day trip on the Jungfrau Railway to the top of the Jungfrau Joch. And then the Golden Pass from Interlaken through to Montreux, where you've got 2 nights by the lake. Beautiful, before heading off to Geneva for flight back. Here, this package, there is some seasonality to note for this package, and it's all because of the Glacier Express. So the Glacier Express, probably the most famous of the train journeys in Switzerland, doesn't run in November. So the gap between halfway between October till halfway between December, where it doesn't run, it can't run. And there's no other train that runs that route, the full route, so the package doesn't work. As you can see here, though, the Glacier Express has the same kind of carriages as the Bernina Express, the panoramic carriages. This is what you get seats reserved in. To admire the view, the full scale of the mountains and the view around you. Where do you start with the Glacier Express? It's the slowest express train in the world. 291 bridges, 91 tunnels, the full length of it. There's first class, it's second class. In both of them, you can order food on board, freshly cooked food. There's excellence class, which we'll have a look at in a little bit. That's special. But yeah, it's amazing over the Rhine gorges, valleys, glaciers, of course, otherwise we call it Glacier Express. Really, really amazing journey. For this particular holiday between Chur and Brig, you're on it for about 4.5 hours. Okay. As of this year, all their carriages are the amazing new ones as well. So the panoramic, brand new panoramic as well. And they become like the Bernina Express, where there are windows that open at the doors, at each door. So again, you get some great images from there as well. They'll have windows opening in the bar car as well, but sadly, social distancing. You can't walk through the train, but obviously, fingers crossed, next year things are looking a bit better. It's going to open up more as well. But yeah, it's amazing. It's an amazing journey. It really is an absolutely amazing journey. Get an idea there of the scenery. It's spectacular. So as mentioned, you take the Glacier Express to Brig, a couple of journeys up to Interlaken, 2 nights in Interlaken, fill that day in Interlaken, traveling up the Jungfrau, which is the highest station in Europe. On a clear day from the top, which is that insert image there, you've got views as far as Germany, Italy, France, across Switzerland. Breathtaking. The difference in temperature is phenomenal. You know, up there's ice, there's snow, you're on a glacier up there. You need to take a woolly hat and a jumper. Down in the valley, it'd be beautiful sunshine, but up there, you'll need a woolly hat and a jumper. It's not just about the top, though, the old adage of the train journey. It's about the journey as well. And on the way up, three different trains. We suggest going up via Lauterbrunnen. So the first leg from Interlaken to Lauterbrunnen, you get an amazing view of the Lauterbrunnen Valley, huge waterfall. You change trains in Lauterbrunnen, and you can actually spend a good half an hour wandering around Lauterbrunnen. There's no reservations, and they're very regular train services every half an hour, so you can decide on the day if you want to have a wander around or if you just want to wait for the next train. Either way, it's a very special part of the world. Every place is stopping, really. The next up, Kleinescheidegg, a tiny little place further up the mountain. The gauge of the train has changed in Lauterbrunnen to Kleinescheidegg. And then Kleinescheidegg through to Jungfrau, top of the Jungfrau Mountain, is another gauge of train that kind of actually passes through the Eiger Mountain. The station itself at the top is inside the Jungfrau Mountain. It's an unbelievable feat of engineering. It really is. Up there, as I said, the view is spectacular. During the summer, spring and summer, you can go out and have a walk on the glacier that's there. When you've had your time up there, you know, there's a Swiss Army knife shop, there's a Swiss watch shop, there's a chocolate shop, there's a couple of bars, a restaurant, look to have some lunch. On the way back down, what we suggest is you take advantage of the brand new cable car that's going to start running, or gondola that's going to start running at the end of this year, down to Grindelwald, which gives you another perspective on the whole geography of the area, because obviously rather than going through the mountain and through the north face of the Eiger, it passes next to the north face of the Eiger. So amazingly spectacular and dramatic, incredibly safe, of course. It also makes it a lot quicker. If you're taking the train down to Grindelwald, you're looking around about a half an hour, 40-minute train journey down to Grindelwald, whereas taking the cable car cuts it down to 15 minutes. So being at the altitude you're up there, it takes it out of you. You can get quite tired. You're around about sort of 13,000 feet above sea level here, so it's pretty high. So it's nice to be able to speed the journey up coming down. And again, you can have an hour or so wandering around Grindelwald, which is beautiful, very, very pretty. At the bottom, Interlaken, if you time it right, the Jungfrau go up in the morning, come back down in the afternoon. Interlaken is in between two lakes. You've got plenty of time just to have a little cruise around one of the lakes as well. Very regular cruise boats going around, lots of little castles and chateaus dotted around the lakes. From Interlaken, you take the Golden Pass train, probably the lesser known of the three, I'd say, train journeys. And it's lovely, as you'd imagine. As you can see, panoramic carriages as they are here. It's different to the Glacier and Bernina, where you don't have to reserve a seat. We include the seat reservations, though. That way, you make sure you're in the panoramic carriages. Okay, so you make sure you've got seats in there. But it's gorgeous coming out of Interlaken. It's coming through the mountains, but it's a little more. I always describe it as being a bit more gentle than the Bernina and the Glacier Express. You're certainly in the snow-covered mountains. And as you come down into Montreux, you drop down and you've got the lake in front of you. So you're coming from the mountains down to the beautiful Mediterranean microclimate that is Montreux. It's gorgeous. But it's a bit more the kind of bit more gentle is the only way I can describe the scenery. You're passing through the Vaud region or the Valais as well, part of the Valais, and through the Vaud, which is where the best cheese and chocolate in Switzerland comes from. You hear a lot of cowbells in this region. The language changes from German to French as you pass into the French-speaking canton. They have English spoken as well on the announcements, but it's an amazing journey. It just highlights the kind of the cosmopolitan nature of Switzerland as a country, I think. But at the end of that holiday, as mentioned, you've got 2 nights in Montreux, which as I said it's got Mediterranean style microclimate. It's a Swiss Riviera on Lake Geneva. You've got Château de Chillon, Chillon Castle, literally 15, 20 minutes walk around the lake from Montreux. You can walk, it's literally walking alongside the lake, or just jump on a boat, have a scenic 5 minute cruise around, but it's gorgeous. Now, something a bit shorter. And as I mentioned, for the Glacier Express, there's a third class of travel, third class of travel. The Grand Glacier Express Excellence class is the class of travel. Okay. Here it's 5 nights, night in Zurich, 2 nights in St. Moritz, and 2 nights in Zermatt. The full length of the Glacier Express, 8.5 hours, amazing scenery. In Zermatt, got the historic Gornergrat cogwheeled railway, second highest station in Europe. Before heading up to Zurich on the way back for your flight home as well. First class throughout, you have to be in first class to be able to travel in excellence class. And you can only do excellence class the full length of the trip, so from Zermatt to St. Moritz or Chur, and vice versa. And this is what it looks like. There's only 20 seats in each carriage, and there's only one carriage per train. It's got its own exclusive bar. Included in the cost is luggage. Your luggage is taken care of, a welcome desk, and your bags. You pick your bags up at your destination. A five-course menu, five-course meal, including cheese course and wine, fitting wine as well, local wine. An iPad. Everyone there in the carriage gets an iPad to tell you a bit of story about the landscape and the sights that you're passing by. You see the seats, there's only two seats opposite one another. There are no tables for four. Okay. The most sought after train seats in Europe. It really is like being in a Michelin star restaurant or a five-star hotel, but on a day train. Of course, we know that the luxury sort of private trains, the Orient Express, for example, where it's five-star luxury and you sleep on board. But to have the experience on a day train, it's fairly unique, to be honest with you. So there's only 20 seats available in each carriage. So it is a truly special, special experience. And to celebrate, be it an anniversary or a special birthday or something, this would be a lovely journey to do it. And of course, you've got two of the most legendary Swiss villages either end of the holiday as well. You've got St. Moritz and Zermatt. So St. Moritz, obviously famous for British holiday making in a way, going back to the early late 19th, early 20th century. The home of winter sports. It was on the old Grand Tour, the first ever sort of British tourists or tour groups. Beautiful throughout the year, not just winter where it's quite lots of skiing. Zermatt as well is very much the same, but spring, summer, those cable cars that take people to the top of the mountain to ski down, they're still open. And you go up there, there's beautiful wild flowers, green pastures, etc. Amazing wildlife. And the lake in St. Moritz is gorgeous. And Zermatt, car free, so there's no cars in Zermatt whatsoever. Get around golf buggies or horse and cart, just dominated by the Matterhorn, the outline of the Matterhorn Mountain. I suppose if you wake up early enough in the morning when the sun comes up, beautiful, the sun reflecting off the Matterhorn and basking in the town in beautiful orange light. Gorgeous. I want to go to Switzerland back again. Scenic Switzerland, my favorite holiday out of all of them. A little bigger, a little longer, but really is a all you want to do and see in Switzerland, really. Flight into and out of Zurich, 2 nights in St. Moritz, day trip return on the Bernina Express, full length of the Glacier Express, 2 nights in Zermatt with a day trip on the Gornergrat Railway. We'll have a look at that shortly. Just the 1 night in Montreux this time, sadly, but still enough time. to pop to Shuyang Castle for a photo. And then full length of the Golden Pass, which Golden Pass Montreux to Interlaken, Interlaken to Lucerne. It's all part of the Golden Pass line. And three nights in Lucerne with a day trip to Mount Pilatus and a day trip to Jungfrau as well. So jam-packed with the most scenic train journeys and the most scenic mountain excursions as well. And some of the most beautiful destinations or cities to stay in. I say city, but villages, towns. We've looked at Zermatt and St. Moritz, but Montreux, Mediterranean microclimate, I've already mentioned it, just the musical heritage with the Montreux Jazz Festival, also the Montreux Casino with its queen his heritage and that sort of things. It's got a beautiful, with the jazz cafe, you know, beautiful place to have some cocktails. They're amazing, very compact as well. They're all so easily walkable, each of these village and towns. Now Lucerne, my favorite place, the real sort of true medieval old town, that chapel bridge which you see there. Lake Lucerne is gorgeous to actually get out and scenic boat rides, and not just Mount Pilatus that we'll have a look shortly, but there's Mount Rigi, Mount Titlis, all great mountain excursions that are just off Lake Lucerne, and spectacular views. So yeah, the Gornergrat. The Gornergrat, easy day trip out of Zermatt. The station is just over the road from Zermatt train station, the highest open air railway in Europe. Second highest station in Europe next to the Jungfrau. Half an hour on the right, half an hour on the way down, train every 20 minutes, going up, crossing over numerous bridges, spectacular bridges, and going through some beautifully fragrant pine tree forests. If you remember the TV show The Night Manager that was on TV a few years ago, the hotel that they run there is halfway up the Gornergrat, a really special place to stay for a special couple of nights, I'd say. Up here again, there's a restaurant for some lunch, or some easy walks during the summer. Don't be surprised if you spot any ibex or marmots up here. Of course, it's dominated by the Matterhorn and the other huge great mountain peaks, which are all there. You've got undisturbed 360 degree view of about 30 different huge mountain peaks over 13,000 feet high. You know, you're really up there in the sky here. And then there's Mount Pilatus, which is my favourite, not just because it's into and out of Lucerne, but it's very special. The steepest cog railway in the world. So each one have got their own. We're number one at this, we're number one at that. The steepest cog railway in the world. The actual train leg only runs between April and October. So when that runs, Mount Pilatus day trip is you jump on a steamboat on Lake Lucerne, round to a little place called Alpnachstad, and that's where the train goes up the mountain. It's about half an hour journey up the mountain, incredibly steep. You're kind of lying back in a way at some parts of it. And if you see that image on the right-hand side, it looks a bit like the Thunderbirds HQ, I always think. Well, it comes up the right-hand side of that side of the mountain is where the train comes up. At the top of the mountain, restaurant, bar, shops, Swiss Army knife, watches, chocolate. There's a lovely hotel, Pilatus Kulm Hotel up here, which only got about 30 rooms. The mountain shuts down around about 6 o'clock when everyone goes home. The only people at the top of the mountain then are the people that are staying at the hotel. So if you're looking for somewhere to stay for a really special occasion, that would be my top of my list. It really would. You've got dinner there and it's beautiful. A big dining room, but the sky at night this high up is something to behold. It really is. The stars dropping down like light bulbs. The peace and quiet, not just at night, but in the morning as well. Lovely. Really, really special. There's some easy walks around there as well. There's a legend of a sleeping dragon in the mountain, which is quite fun. But either way, if you're spending the night or just doing a day trip, amazing views. When you're done, come back down the mountain via this cable car that you see there. That changes onto another cable car before you come down into Lucerne. And that comes down the other side of the mountain from where the cog railway train goes up. outside of April and October, so the winter time, the cogwheel train can't go. So it is just up and down via the cable car and gondola, but still spectacular. Amazing views and spectacular and great fun at the top as well. Well, I hope they've whetted the appetite a little bit. Of course, there's more. Of course, there's more. Some smaller, the Montrose City Break. We saw Montrose already, but if you just want to stay in one place for a few nights, Montrose is a great option. You've got that Mediterranean style microclimate. You've got the mountains nearby. There's a great mountain railway called Rocheuse du Nez from Montrose, which is really easy. Up you go to the top of the mountain, amazing views, beautiful wildlife, etc. Throughout the year, the top is covered in snow, of course, but really lovely vineyards in Montreux as well. The Bernina Express, we looked at it going into Italy. You can combine it, of course you can, with any destination in Italy. Milan, trains go everywhere in Italy from Milan, but the Venice Simplonite Express and the Bernina Express would be a tour de force of rail experiences. You've got the onboard amazing luxury and unique experience of being on the VSOE, but you've also got the world-class scenery of the Bernina Express. If you're looking for a special occasion celebration, that would be certainly one of the best ways to celebrate it. And Venice via the Alps, probably our best-selling holiday, 3 nights in Venice. And it's really scenic route to get there as well. Via the Alps, all of our holidays say via the Alps would be the same routing, which is with an overnight stay in Geneva. And then the following morning, it's a direct train from Geneva to Venice. It's via the Simplon Pass. Which is where the name Venice Simplon Orient Express gets the Simplon bit from, the historic route that it used to take. Coming through a beautiful mountain pass, the Simplon Pass, but then also comes by Lake Maggiore and skirts around Lake Garda before coming into Venice. So really, really scenic journey. And then, of course, Venice at the end of it. But we've also have Rome via the Alps, Florence via the Alps, Italy via the Alps. Well, if you'd like to see even more, of course, head to the website railbookers.co.uk. Make your way to destinations where you can find Switzerland, of course, or any other destinations which you might be interested in. Holiday types is always good as well. You'll see lots of different options there: scenic trains, luxury trains, sleeper trains, red trains, blue trains. You get the idea. And if you've enjoyed this or found it helpful, please, next week we're doing an overnight rail journeys with Railbookers. So sleeper trains, top holidays. And then in 2 weeks' time, those five popular holidays closer to home. We've just launched some holidays around Ireland, going up to Scotland, or even if you're fair enough, over to France next year. And in 3 weeks' time, top seven holidays for 2021, what we're seeing as themes in terms of patterns, people looking for 2021. Well. Questions. Elke, great question. Thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Netherlands, absolutely. Yeah. So the Eurostar, direct Eurostar between London and Amsterdam, it's brilliant. It's great. And it's opened up the Netherlands, not just Amsterdam, of course, as well, and get further afield. So, yeah, absolutely. There's going to be more holidays coming that way. Stephen, yeah, no problem. Sleeper trains, it's really interesting, the world of sleeper trains, because you're absolutely right. A lot of countries have sadly said we're not going to run the sleeper trains anymore. The most obvious and the saddest one really is in Spain. Renfe needs to run the train across Spain into Portugal, and they don't. So there's essentially only one way of getting to Portugal by direct train, and that's via Galicia to the north. Whereas people like Austrian Rail, Deutsche Bahn, and some regards and Swiss are doing more and more. So there's more routes coming through Central Europe, which is brilliant. It's really exciting to see. We just hope that more countries take note of the business model in terms of people wanting to travel by sleeper train and getting these lines back. Because there used to be some amazing lines between Paris and Berlin, for example. It makes perfect sense, but sadly it wasn't making enough money for the operators back before. And Tello, sadly as well, the train from Paris into Italy. From all the noises we've been hearing, it's not going to be returning at all. It's really sad, of course, from Paris through to Venice or Paris to Milan. Very sad indeed. But there is a lovely sleeper route from Munich or Vienna through to Venice, which is quite fun. Susan, Rome via Switzerland. Absolutely. Yeah. So you've got many options, of course. There's got the via the Alps route, which we looked at the end, where you go to Geneva and then take the Simplon Pass to Milan and then direct train from Milan to Rome. Or you could take the Bernina Express as well. I'd suggest a night in Milan on the Bernina Express. So you could do Zurich or St. Moritz or Chur through down through the Bernina Express overnight in Milan and then onwards to Rome the next day. Yeah. It was, Stephen, wasn't it? Yeah, Paris Berlin. It was a great route. It made perfect sense. It really did. So easy. But yeah, fingers crossed some operators are going to see a bit more sense in the new year. The great thing about it is you can actually, social distancing isn't too much of a problem on a sleeper train. You've got your own private cabin, you're shown into that cabin, you're not mixing with anybody, etc. Oh, Gillian, great question. Or incorporate Vienna and the Glacier Express. You certainly could, yeah. There's regular trains, Zurich, Vienna, and then down from there, either way around, you can fly up to Zurich, Vienna, and then come back through Switzerland or vice versa. Yeah, loads, plenty of options, absolutely. Well, thank you very much, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed it. I really do. Thank you for joining me. As said, next week we'll get an email follow on. You get an email later on today, actually, with a recording of the webinar if you want to catch up on anything like that. Any questions specifically for me, don't hesitate in emailing me, gareth.jones@railbookers.com. Thank you very much, everybody. Enjoy the rest of the day and keep well. Cheers now. Bye-bye.